All right, the first thing I want to mention is that I am doing fine because I am not engaging fully or waterboarding is what he would have called it. When I last talked to my therapist, I felt that I wanted to share my Tony Robbins education that I've been learning, or even some self-help things, motivational speaking videos, or just things that I've been listening to try to put me in the right frame of mind. And I spoke to my therapist about it, and he said that I am probably talking about it too much to my husband, and I'd be waterboarding him like a torture device, constantly talking about it. So I kind of felt, right, I guess I can't really be myself and talk about it whenever I feel the need to talk. And I felt shut down. I felt stifled. Then we went to our marriage counseling session, and we talked about lots of things, but that was something that also came up, where I feel that my therapist is telling me I might be waterboarding my husband if I talk about it too much, and our marriage counselor said, no, go ahead and talk about it. Go ahead and be open. Go ahead and learn. Go ahead and run, take off running. But don't expect him to go as fast as you are. Don't expect Jim to be 100% like you are. That's not fair for you to expect that of him. But in my mind, I feel like if I can't just open and talk freely, then I'm being stifled. I've got to keep my mouth shut. I got to be careful of what I say. I got to be careful to not overconsume myself so that I want to talk and feel stifled. So I haven't really been watching stuff. I haven't really been looking into things, right? And then something came up when I was watching. I got onto YouTube and it mentioned the four different types of narcissists. And I learned about the covert narcissist, and that really resonated with me as a behavior my husband has traits of, if not the actual disorder. But when I was watching, I felt that rather than dwell or focus on this diagnosis, I would just observe the behaviors that he's displaying and learn how to best interact with those behaviors. Which I've learned, you don't combat a covert narcissist, you don't challenge them, you don't upset them, you don't ruffle their feathers, you don't give them reason to belittle you. You know, I'm learning lots about stuff like that. But then at the same time, that just goes right back to feeling stifled. That goes right back to feeling like I can't be myself around a covert narcissist. And that's true. You really can't. So I feel like I'm stuck, which goes right back to what I've been saying all this time. I feel stuck. I feel like I can't be myself. I feel like I can't be who I truly am. And when I try, I have these upsets. I have these depression modes. I get really upset. I cry. And I am just extremely emotional when I try to be myself and I'm shut down. So now that I know that the behaviors that my husband display can either be survived or managed, I'd rather manage, right? I'd rather walk on the eggshells to prevent him from acting a certain way. Be very considerate about his feelings and his thoughts so that I don't have to deal with the emotional upset when he doesn't like what I say or do. And then I just feel trapped some more. So I'd rather do the managing than the confrontation. Because I've been trying to do the confrontation and that doesn't work. And also, some people say, well, if you don't confront it, if you don't talk about it, if you don't figure this out, then he'll always get away with it. He'll always think he can do this, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, I don't think challenging it teaches him anything. I don't think it helps him. I don't think things are improving when it comes to having discussions and talks. And there's a little bit of eggshell walking on his part where he's trying to be more careful and mindful of what he does and says, but not to the extreme that I've been going through, and I don't necessarily expect him to. I don't know. I don't know what I expect. I don't even know what I want. I want to be able to talk about it. Okay, we talked about it. Okay, let's done. Let's move on. But no, if we talk about it, it becomes an upset. It becomes a catastrophe on his end. He thinks he's got to fight to the death. He's got to be angry and upset and everything. So I just kind of throw my hands up and say, all right, I guess I'm not supposed to upset you. And you know, I do have to recognize that he's mentioned the same thing. If he has a thing that he's upset about and he brings it to me and I get emotional and suicidal and get all upset and everything, he's like, fine, I guess I can't have a feeling. But really, where do you think I learned that behavior from? What do you think happens when you constantly get upset when wife has an upset, or you defend an anger and blah 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 and turn it around and everything like that? It's like, you know, we both do it to each other, I guess. That's the bottom line. I don't really have an answer. I don't really think therapy is the thing I need to do anymore. Maybe. What am I getting out of therapy, I guess, is another question I have. Because when I was going through all the upsets with my husband, I really feel like I needed the therapy. Today, I don't know if I do. So I don't want to say that I'm making a decision for my future self, because my future self might feel like I need it. The nice part is I don't have to pay a copay, so my job can continue to pay for my therapy. Anyway, I'll talk to y'all later. Bye-bye.